মাইকেল নগর শিক্ষানিকেতন হায়ার সেকেন্ডারি গভর্নমেন্ট স্পন্সার্ড কোয়েড ইংলিশ মিডিয়াম স্কুল হ্যাজ টেকেন অ্যান এক্সেলেন্ট ইনিশিয়েটিভ অফ টিচিং অ্যান্ড মেক আওয়ার স্টুডেন্টস লার্ন ডে টু ডে লেসন্স থ্রু অডিও অ্যান্ড ভিডিও ইন আওয়ার ইউটিউব চ্যানেল Teachers of all the subjects are working hard to enhance this online classes in amidst of this pandemic situation. It is a request to all the teachers, students and guardians to click the bell icon and subscribe our channel. So today we are going to start the next section, that is growth and development, which is a continuation of the second chapter, that is continuity of life of class 10. So before getting into the details of growth and development, first let us know that when does an organism, or when is an organism actually, how is it born and how is the process of growth and development gradually taking place. So we know basically the union, the fertilization is the first step if you are considering growth and development. So the very first step is fertilization, which is basically the union of two gametes, that is the male gamete and the female gamete. They unite together by the process of fertilization, and as a result of which the very first cell is formed, and this cell is known as the zygote, right? Now once this zygote is produced, then different kinds of complex processes starts forming inside that cell. As a result, the cell divides and continues its process towards a multicellular organism. So when the zygote is formed, then what happens, this zygote, it starts interacting with the environment. Now environment in what thing? It means that environment, it is actually interacting with the first, before that particular zygote forms an embryo and comes out of the mother's womb, it is interacting with the internal environment, that is within the mother's womb. And once it has come out of the womb, then it will interact with the environment, and gradually throughout this entire process, the growth process and the development will continue simultaneously. So that is what I have written over here. So let me just repeat once more. So the very first step is the union of the gametes, that is the male gamete and the female gamete, through the process of fertilization. Then we are coming to the formation of the very first cell, that is the zygote. Then once the zygote is formed, it undergoes constant interaction with the environment, both internal environment and external environment, and that results in the, and that initiates the process of growth and development. Now before getting into further through the chapter, we should know that growth and development, they are always, these terms, they are always taken together, but we have to understand that they are not the same, but they are very much interrelated to each other. Okay, they are very much interrelated to each other, and they always occur simultaneously in a body. Okay, so now on the next thing, we will go to the definition of growth and its different phases. So we are coming to the definition, or you can say that we are coming to the definition of growth, which says it is the irreversible increase in the size of organisms, to be precise. In very easy words, what is growth? It is basically the increase in size of that particular organism, and also in the increase in number. Like here I have written increase in the number of cells through cell division. So this takes place through cell division, and increase in the size of the cells through cell growth. So this is basically the definition of growth, and it is quantitative in nature. That means, what is the meaning of this word quantitative? It means that it is measurable, like you can measure the size of a cell, or how many cells are there, that you can measure the height, you can measure the weight, right? So this is what is growth is. So that is why growth is always quantitative in nature. Next we are coming to the phases of growth. The growth is divided into three basic phases. Now what are those phases? Number one is cell division, then comes the cell enlargement, and at the last comes cell differentiation. So what is cell division? Cell division is the process by which one cell divides into two and then they again divide through the process of mitosis. We know that very well. So that is at first that take place when the cell they first divide. Now when they divide, then they start its enlargement, that is different kinds of complex processes starts within the cell that results in the maturation of the cell. So that is the cell enlargement, which includes the increase in the size, for example, increase in the size of stem, root, etc. And the last part is the cell division. Like once the cell matures, then what happens? They are divided into division of labor takes place rather, where their specific cells are assigned to perform specific duties. So that is what cell differentiation is, which is also a part of growth. So now we'll come to development. Development is more of a complex process. It is more of a whole process. In growth, we were basically talking about the quantitative approach. That is, we were talking about the increase in size and increase in number, right? But when we are talking about development, we are talking about the wholesome development or wholesome growth of the organism. Not only its increase in size, that is its physical size, but also its physiological developments, its mental developments, okay. So, it is the process which involves an overall approach. That is not only physical growth, but also the mental and the physiological growth as well, which is it involves the differentiation of cells. We have learned this in growth. It involves the increase in dry mass, that includes growth, increase in the complexity of the organism. So it not only deals with the physical size, but it is also dealing with the overall growth of that particular organism that takes place throughout its lifespan. Now we are talking about the phases of development. Now phases of development has five basic steps. The first three we have already done in growth, that is cell division, cell enlargement and cell differentiation. But the other two which are included in this part, that is cell movement and cell death. Now what is cell movement? Cell movement is basically the process by which the cells, they shift their position from one place to another into specific positions, of course. There are specific places where they move to in order to function in a specific way. For example, suppose in case of our immune system, we know that once a germ or a virus or a bacteria enters our body reacts against it. It launches soldiers, right? That is the WBC or the leukocytes. Now these macrophages and the different types of neutrophils, basophils, all these kind of soldier cells, they come to the specific site of that wound or that specific site of that infection and they fight the germs. So that is their shifting their position from one place to a specific position to undergo a specific function for the development of the body. So that is included in the development part. Okay. And the last part is cell death. We cannot consider cell death as growth, right? But when we are talking about development, we should definitely take cell death into account, because once it has done, the cell has matured totally and it has done all its functions. Now, what will happen? It will die. Each and every cell has a minimum lifespan. So, after that lifespan, it will die. So, that is senescence. We have come across this term senescence. So, what happens? They die and they get replaced by new cells. So, this entire process, basically from birth to death, whatever the events are occurring, that is entirely included under the development, whatever, okay? So, now we have come to the end of the video where we will be learning about the lifespan development in humans, okay? We will be learning about the phases, the different phases of development in humans. So, as you can see that I have divided the entire period of a lifespan of a human into a number of stages. There are 8 stages. The first stage being the prenatal stage, which is basically inside the mother's womb. There what happens? It is the journey from being a zygote to the fetus. okay, until it is coming out of the body. So inside the mother's womb. The next stage comes infancy and toddlerhood, which includes 0 to 2 years, right? Up to 2 years of age, what kind of changes that we see in an organism or in a human being or in a baby between an age of 0 to 2 years? We see some involuntary reflexes, yes? They don't understand anything, but they have some reflexes. Like if I put some light to their eyes, they'll blink like those. Keen sense of hearing, they can hear. Slow talking, slowly, you know, blabbering something, they learn that, and talking and walking. The next stage comes early childhood, which is basically 2 to 6 years of age, which includes preschool. So now by this age, the particular baby has been admitted to a particular school, which is basically preschool, and he or she is learning language, the different, and they are having this sense of self. That means they are starting to identify that he or she is an individual. The next one comes middle childhood, which includes the age of 6 to 11 years, where they are now 6 to 11 means what? Up to class 5 or 6. So then what they are doing, they are testing their academic skills, maybe some co-curricular activities. Brain reaches the maximum size over here. So in the middle childhood, in this phase, our brain reaches the adult size, but the development doesn't stop, the development continues of the brain. Social relationships beyond family. So at this time, the child recognizes a few people which are beyond its family, and there is a sense of love towards them. Then comes adolescence, which is 12 to 18 or 20 years, which is, we know, the sexual maturation or the pubertal period, where the sexual maturation takes place, the sense of love, fear, freedom, all this creeps in within the particular mind of that particular adolescent. Sense of freedom is very much in this age. People try, the boys and the girls, they always try to do whatever they want. They try to be this adult. They try to seem themselves as an adult person. Next comes this early childhood, which is basically 20 to 40 years of age. What does it include? It includes financial stability. So now, as I have completed my academic career, so now I am starting with my financial career. I am having financial stability. I am getting married to someone. And maybe that means I am settling down. I am settling down to a level. Next comes the middle childhood, which includes the age of 40 to 60 years. What does it have? It has experience. Now we are gaining different career experiences. We are now experienced about life and everything. So now, psychological aging. At this age, the people start thinking that, we have to grown old now. So gaining expertise. So that is another part of middle childhood, where we are gaining expertise in certain fields. Suppose it can be whichever work or whichever job I'm doing, I'm expertized in that. So the last part is the late adulthood, that includes this 60 years of age till death, till you're living. So it also psychological aging starts in this phase, but physiological aging comes in the late adulthood, where your organs, they start, you know, they become weak and everything. Restrictions to various types of work. You cannot run at this age. Suppose there are people who are still fit at this age, which is good. Everybody should be fit. But mostly what happens, they have different kinds of diseases and different kinds of health issues at this age. So they are restricted to various kinds of work. So this is the entire lifespan development of humans. With this, we have come to the end of this video, where we are discussing about the growth and development of organisms.
Thanks for watching. Leave a like and comment. Subscribe. And do share the video among your friends.